Well, hi. Several people asked today how I made this dashboard in my traveler's notebook. It's got pockets here and here, here and here. I just made it from a file folder, so I'm going to show you how I did that. Just start with a regular file folder, and the size of the inserts, the size of the notebook is a B6, so that means the inserts are 5x7. So the one that's in there now, I made it exactly 5x7. And it's actually a little bit too narrow. I need it to be more like 5 1/4 so that it has enough room to wrap around an insert and still meet the edges of the insert. So I'm going to go with 5 1/4 instead of just 5. So I score both of the sides of the file folder. Okay. So I've scored them both at 5 1/4, and then the process is like that. And it doesn't look even at all. Good Lord, what am I doing? All right, 5 1/4, 5. Huh. I said 5 1/4, but I scored at 5. All right, there's 5 1/4. Okay, now, 5 1/4, and then I need it to be 7 inches tall. And I like to use these uneven sides here, so I'm going to go with 7 here. And, you know, it's not perfect, but it's just a file folder. Okay, so now we have this end that folds up. And these ends that fold in, folds in half, and we've got our 5 1/4 by 7. However, this is too bulky, right? So need to cut out the middle where it folds up. And I just cut a little bit on either side of that center area. In fact, I'm gonna cut to the incorrect score mark that I did. All right, so just cut some out of the middle. There. So now these fold up. And then what I did in these, I want these pockets to be slant pockets like this, and then I want these pockets on the outside. So I need to cut here so that one side can go up this way, one side goes up the other way. So again, look at the where the fold is. So there's the fold. So I'm just going to cut a little bit off here, right up to that score line. And the same thing on this side, right up to the score line. Okay, so now these guys can go up. These guys can go up this way and make pockets up here. And, you know, I had to cut this, and now it's at an angle that I don't like, so I'm going to kind of re-fold it a little bit, and that's why there's washi tape on the seams. So all these little not-quite-perfect bits can be camouflaged. Okay. Of course, I tidied up so I can't find anything, like my bone folder. Oh, disorganization on a Monday night. Here we go. All right. So refolding that, refolding this a little bit. And the other thing I did in order to make these pockets here, see they're just fastened on one side, I cut some hinges. I just sacrificed one entire craft file folder and cut it in 1-inch strips, which I folded in half, and I'm just using these as construction pieces. So this one will go in here. So make it able to close that pocket. This one over here to close this pocket. Okay, so just glue this in here. This off at a little bit of an angle. you know what? These do not have to be perfect. They are file folders. They'll be just fine, however you do them. I use something called Art Glitter Glue. That's just the brand name. It's not glittery. What I like about it, it dries very fast, and it also dries clear. Scotch Quick Dry is good. I used that for many years, but it dries fast, but it dries white. And I am not very neat when I am gluing, so I didn't like having all those white glue spots on my album pages. This Art Glitter Glue dries much clearer. So I folded this in half, got the fold to the outside edge, gluing these hinges to the pocket and to the base. And then we have a pocket. Of course, I forgot to round this corner. I'm going to pull that off of there. And I'm going to get glue in my quarter rounder. That's all right. All right. Now we're talking. There. Okay, and then this one around that corner. Put this hinge in here. Trim this off a little bit. I have thread all over my scissors. It's been a very disorganized day for me, so this is the third time I've tried to do this video tonight. Been one of those days. So, glue this hinge in here. It does take this glue a little bit longer to dry on this particular project because this is a very shiny, glossy file folder. I probably should have taken the time to rough it up a little bit with a emery board or a file of some kind. I have bought these at the Dollar Tree, I think. They're those large emery boards. I should have roughed up the surface a little bit so the glue would dry better. But I didn't, so it is what it is. All right, so we got two pockets. Just trying to line this one up a little bit better. And again, refolding down here. All right, there's the two outside pockets. And then the inside pockets, I just like to have it be a slant pocket so you can put things in and see them. So I just kind of arbitrarily pick an amount that I'm going to fold it by and fold it. You can measure if you want to. I am not in a measuring mood. Alright, so I do try and make them even with each other. Okay, and then I'm just going to glue those over to the inside. Just to give that a finished edge. A couple more hinges to go in here, and I have neglected to cut enough of them. So I'm going to cut them off of this file folder, which was my first attempt, and I cut it off instead of folding it. So this is a totally useless thing. So I'm going to cut a couple of inch strips that are folded in half, and I'll use these for my hinges in here. This was a pile of, or a package of orange file folders that I got at Tuesday morning. They're all different patterns. It was this geometric pattern, and then the sort of herringbone and the polka dots. I like the polka dots. Alright, so now we have some hinges to go in here to close up these pockets. Yes, that's my fancy measuring. Fold it and cut it off. There we go, and this one will go over here, and then we'll be done, and we'll dress it up with a little washi tape. So I'm just going to rough these up a little bit so they hold glue better. kind of like they do if you go get a manicure and they buff the top of your nail. That's why it makes the gel nail or the nail polish stick better. Just try and take that gloss off. So why do I do it this way rather than just glue down the side? Because I want to be able to use the whole width of the pocket. So with this, you know, you can put something in that's this wide. If I glued down the edge, I could only put something in that was, you know, a half an inch shorter. And I like it. It gives a more finished edge and it gives you more room for your pocket. This edge looks really bad, so we are definitely doing some washi tape decorative camouflage on this one. Yes, that's upside down. Too bad. Mm-hmm. Ever have one of those days where everything's pretty much upside down and you just don't care? Well, it's one of those days. All right, so that is the construction. That's it. That's the whole thing. We now have a 5x7 folder, actually 5 1/4x7, that will fit in a B6 traveler's notebook and wrap around a 5x7 insert. And you have pockets here. Go all the way to the edge because I used hinges. And pockets in here. So I have some other washi tape that I think I'll use this time. What did I use over here? The sort of on this one I used the washi tape that has drawing things, has a notebook and pencil, compass, protractor, eraser. And I think for this one I will use the washi tape that's all about art supplies. So we have paint. And an easel, paint brushes, paint palette. It's very cute. So let's see. Yeah, probably should have done this before I glued it down. But we'll make it work. Yeah, definitely should have done this before I glued it down. All right. Well, it continues to be one of those days, I guess. Yeah, I'm turning off the camera. You get the idea. Bye.